Aries, I hope you're all doing well. In today's reading, we'll be looking at whoever you're thinking about for the rest of the year. We have Aries bottom deck energy, Cancer, Libra, Gemini, Virgo, Scorpio. Those are the signs. But it is energy we're looking at, so signs don't really matter. Who this person is, we have Ten of Wands, Ace of Pentacles. Who they are, they're very hardworking. Can be an Earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Maybe someone who's starting a new job, but they're saying they have a lot of responsibilities and they are busy with financial matters here. Some of you, this may even be a new person with the Ace. How they're viewing you, we have Ace of Swords in reverse, Four of Swords. They're viewing you as someone who is not communicating. You're on a break and no contact here. You're not doing anything. How they're feeling about you, we have Seven of Pentacles, Six of Wands. They're wanting to invest in this. They still have hope. They want your recognition. They want you to give them attention. And they're still waiting on this. I don't see much action coming from the both of you, but you both seem to be still invested. At least this person is wanting to invest. Let's clarify. We have Fool, King of Pentacles, bottom deck. There may be a new financial endeavor here. You may be taking some sort of risk when it comes to money, or this person may. Why is Seven of Pentacles here? For how this person will be feeling about Aries. Page of Pentacles. Some of you work with this person, or they're wanting to be friends with you, get to know you better. They see a lot of potential in this situation. Why is Six of Wands here? Ace of Wands in reverse. Yeah, this person's not initiating anything. They like you, but they're more so observing, stalking, than they are doing anything about this situation. They're very physically attracted to you. Why is Six of Wands here? For how this person will be feeling. Wheel of Fortune. Yeah, they feel it's not the right time. One or both of you have a lot of options. This person may feel you are also more so getting in your energy, but it can be mutual. Seven of Cups, Six of Wands, someone who gets a lot of attention, they're maybe keeping their options open. There's other people involved here. Some of you, this is a social media or online connection where this person is investing in you, but they're also keeping their options open. It's almost not wanting to put all their eggs in one basket, but you're the one they see potential with. And if this is a past person, they feel that they're slowing things down, but there's a fear of losing out here because they realize you're someone who's popular, you get a lot of attention. That's what I'm getting with the Six of Wands. Their intentions, we have Knight of Swords in reverse, clarified by Four of Cups upright. Their intentions is to not communicate and leave things stagnant. They're very moody when it comes to the situation. They may be holding on to some sort of grudge because I did ask, why are they not communicating? We have Death in reverse. They're holding on to something from their past. If this person has history with you, there may have been an argument, right? They're holding on to a grudge. And others of you, it can be a past relationship. Something that happened to them here that they're having a hard time releasing. There's resistance, right? Why is Four of Cups here for this person's intentions toward... Oh, Aries. Yeah, they're holding back. Their intentions is to hold back. They have a lot of passion for you, but they're restraining themselves. There's a strong urge to come towards you, but they're not. Page of Cups in reverse. What action they'll take towards you? We have a Magician in reverse, Hanged Man upright. Magician is also Mercury. So we have all the cards that indicate communication in reverse. So it's almost you're mirroring one another. You're both not initiating communication. Some of you, this person may feel powerless, right? They may feel that you'll reject them even if they were to come towards you, which is why they're sort of hanging back. They haven't left this situation, Aries. They're waiting. What are they waiting on? I wish you would make the first move. That was at the bottom deck of one of your oracle cards. So they're waiting on you to make the first move. That is why they haven't left the situation. They still have hope for this, but they don't want to be the one that's initiating. There's a little bit of stubbornness with strength and Four of Cups. So their actions is they're holding back and not doing anything. How you'll be feeling, we have Tower, Judgment in reverse, Eight of Cups in reverse, clarified by Knight of Pentacles. So I was talking about the mirroring. You're saying you're avoiding them and you're saying no second chances, but you're also emotionally holding on to this. Knight of Pentacles is also standing in one position. You're both still wanting to invest in one another. You see potential. It's mutual, right? But there's a little bit of stubbornness coming through. For whatever reason, right? A lot of it'll be different reasons for each one of you. Some of you may be justified, right? If this person is committed. We did have the King of Pentacles, bottom deck energy. That can be a married person, right? So you're saying, you know, I'm having a hard time letting go of this, but I'm keeping you as a friend, Knight of Pentacles. They were also offering you the page. Some of you may feel, you know, I'm giving more than you are. You're bringing the page, I'm bringing the knight. So there's a few reasons why you're holding back, right? It'll be different. But why this person is holding back is because they're waiting for you to reach out to them, and you're not doing that. So that nothing's moving forward. Hangman. In your outcome, we have Moon upright, Justice in reverse, Eight of Swords upright. I see a lot of fears, confusion, indecision in your outcome. No one's doing anything. Why is the Moon here? There's a lot of fantasizing, dreaming about the other. Yeah, as I say dreaming, Star, Seven of Cups. Seven of Cups. Why is the Moon here for Aries' outcome? Yeah, this talks about the fourth house. Moon, Cancer, Four of Wands. Ten of Pentacles. A commitment, a marriage. Why is Justice in reverse here? Some of you, this person could be getting out of a commitment, right? Justice in reverse can be a divorce. And they were why they weren't communicating with you was Death in reverse. They have to let go of something before they can invest in you, which is why they were slowing things down. That's for some of you. Why is Justice in reverse? Hermit. Yeah, someone has a decision to make, but they're having a hard time listening to their intuition. Can be you, because we have Queen of Wands and High Priestess in reverse. So as a result, someone is holding back. They're in hermit mode. But there's a lot of overthinking, overanalyzing. Oh, why is the Eight of Swords here? There may even be some insecurities here with the Eight of Swords. Why is Eight of Swords here? Yeah, someone's confused. Should I go left or should I go right? We have this way or that way on Chariot. Strong reference to fourth house here. Some of you, should I give this person another chance? This situation doesn't seem to be over. But the issue here is there's a lot of potential because this person was keeping an eye on you, right? Even though they weren't communicating, they dream about you. They think about, you know, the memories. Six of Cups, Ten of Cups. Some of you may have had a family, children with them, but there is some codependency that needs to be worked on here. Nine of Cups, Nine of Pentacles. Very few of you, I'm not getting this as a strong message. There's someone here who's already committed but fantasizing about you. So you need to be careful and establish stronger boundaries. Make sure, because in your advice, we have Hierophant and Five of Wands. Your guides your guides, the higher power, whatever you believe in, is in advising you to put up strong boundaries and not participate in any conflict drama around you. They want you to maintain some sort of balance. I think you were following this advice because the situation throws you off balance, and as a result, you were withdrawing. So they're saying that is the right approach to take here with Hierophant, Five of Wands. Don't back down. Don't settle for less is what the Hierophant is indicating here. Okay, let's get their messages. We have sex makes me feel desirable and wanted. Some of you, this person in the past was only offering you something physical. You may have turned them down. Ace of Wands in reverse. Or they're just physically very attracted to you. How many times do I have to say I'm sorry before you forgive me? Yeah, they are sorry for what they've put you through. But someone here, she has her arms crossed. Gender doesn't matter. But one of you may be turning down the apology, you know? You're still upset about what happened here. And I was seeing this in your feelings, judgment in reverse, no second chances. You may want this person to prove themselves. We have tough girl. Your strength intimidates them. Tough girl or boy. Your strength intimidates them. They're hoping you make the first move. Wow, I actually didn't read this, but we have word for word two different decks. I wish you would make the first move. They're hoping you make the first move. But don't. Any person worth having must match your strength. So this is a strong message today, Aries. Synchronicity. That reason they're not coming towards you, they're restraining themselves with the strength, is because waiting on you. Why is this person waiting on you? Why aren't they? I don't know what's going on. Is it because some of you, is it because they've apologized in the past? You said no with the Ace of Swords in reverse, so now they're saying they have no choice but to wait for you to come towards them when you're ready. That is also a possibility. We have silver lining. Every situation offers something positive. You may not see it immediately. Sometimes not getting what you wish for is a blessing in disguise. I'll let you interpret that according to your situation. And we have believe and trust. Always playing it safe can mean denying yourself the chance to find true happiness. Take a leap of faith and step out of your comfort zone. I was getting a lot of reference to your home, the fourth house, which can talk about comfort, familiarity. So that may be a dilemma here, right? You're sort of remaining in your bubble with the Hermit, and they're saying you'll have to take that risk, which may be scary here with the Eight of Swords, right? And we started off your reading bottom deck energy. We had the Fool, which can also talk about the leap of faith. And if we look at the bottom deck energy for this advice deck, we also have collaboration, mature man, mature woman, focus on your priorities, conversation, romance. So I do see a couple here, Aries, mature man, mature woman. Maybe the same person whose energy I'm picking up on, maybe someone new. But they're saying you're spreading yourself too thin. Focus on what is your priority right now, and you'll see the light at the end of the tunnel. You're making progress. I'm not sure what this is referring to, scattering your energy. Is it because you have a lot of options? You're confused? Who do you choose? Because we have a social media connection paired with romance. Some of you, you're exploring your options online, dating. Some of you, not for everyone. Or there may just be someone you're getting to know back and forth text messages, or this can be future energy as well. What it's indicating to me is that there's the past person waiting for you to make that move, and then that you also have options. Let's get one more for your advice, Aries. What advice do you have for Aries? Taking you for a ride, cold peace. Careful not to be taken for a ride and waste your time chasing lies. Take control of your love life and realize you're good enough. You deserve better. This is, yeah, interesting. You're good enough. You deserve better. Take control of your love life. Chariot. Step into the driver's seat. Lead the way is what they're saying. So if this person's been treating you unfairly, cold peace, They want you to take back your power and reflect with the Hermit. You know, is this person worth your time, your energy, you waiting on them? So that is a decision you'll have to make moving forward. You have options, so this is, you're not limited in any way. So don't feel that way. You may not see it right now, but there will be new possibilities opening up for you once you're ready. But yes, Aries, that is what I have for you. Take care of yourself. I'll see you next week. Bye.